welcome to episode 3 of my Blind LP of Valkyria Chronicles. So, just starting off where we left last time, because this, I don't think there's any grinding to do, unless I were to go redo missions, I'm not sure. So let's check out the other things. So, what's the training field about?
Welcome to your worst nightmare. I'm the guy who's gonna whip you lazy blobs into shape. Still, I can't work miracles here. No amount of drilling beats real combat experience. I want you all to go out there, kick some imp tail, and then show me what you learned. I will train that experience into something you can actually use. Level you bums up. But don't go trying to hog all the glory. A squad's a team, and we got no need for stars. You will train as a class and level up by class. Scout level 2, scout level 3, you get it? When the scouts level up, that means each and every one of them goes up that level. You hear me, maggots? Any of you think he's better than the rest of the team, go home now!
I would fucking leave right there. Like, get me the hell out of that military.
Alright, now I'll show you lowlifes how this whole thing actually works. It ain't complicated. First you go out there and fight. Then divvy up that experience here. Once the experience you cram into a soldier class clears a set amount, it'll level up. Picking which class to level up and when is your job as the squad leader. Now give it a go.
Okay.
Train all you want. I've got all day.
Okay, so that's... This isn't bad. So, I've done a little bit of looking into some stuff. I didn't really read through anything like super hard, but there are 10 levels, I believe, to each class, or 11, and reaching certain things gives the classes like a bonus in certain ways. Like, I believe the max of the scout or whatnot is a grenade launcher, which is apparently really useful. Assign that.
You're better than this. Push those limits.
Okay, scout level up.
Good work, maggots. You're one level closer to human.
So are we like larva or something? Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get scout to level 3 because I do have more scouts than anything, so that would be useful.
I got no use for tears. Sweat, sweat, sweat.
Okay.
Good work, maggots! You're one...
Yep. Okay. So, I can't level them up again. I'm gonna level the sniper up. One. The engineer doesn't use as much XP. I can level both these up one time, because I'm not sure what's gonna be actually useful.
You're better than the...
Okay. Okay, see, new potentials.
Looks like that session beat a new potential out of the snipers.
Okay. So, I don't know what potential is. Oh, okay. I get it. So, what it does is... what's going on? Loyal teammate. So, I'm guessing... Okay, so it basically just gives them an extra one on top of whatever they are. That is probably, like, a bonus. I didn't check out what he was prior to this. But, okay. So he's a child of nature. Big-hearted. Okay, so if he reaches zero, he gets revived. So that's fine. Healing powers are occasionally increased. And loyalty matters. Surrounded by us, he feels the drive and energy to work that much harder. Enjoying a boost in abilities. Okay, that's not bad. And you can see the level. Okay, so this game basically says, like, yeah, you're not gonna have any people that carry the team, essentially. I'm going to just put that there.
I got no use for...
Yeah.
Got it. That's how training by class works. Now get out there and rack up some experience.
Okay.
Oh, And there's one more thing to add. Sometimes leveling up a unit class will unlock a hidden potential in them. You can think of potentials as the natural abilities your soldiers have inside them. Those abilities will form a big part of your strength in the field, so keep them in mind. Other times, leveling up a class will earn you clearance for a new order. Here, as long as we're talking about it, I'll teach you a classic, a real golden oldie.
Earned evade boost. This order raises one ally's evasion skills. Okay.
Orders are special commands you can give out as the squad leader. They can save your tail. It doesn't take a genius to see that leveling up your soldiers is the best way to beef up your squad. The soldiers will get stronger, and you just might unlock new potentials and orders. All that just from me working you sorry bums into the dirt. I just hope you maggots are ready for a real workout the next time I see you here.
Okay. So this game basically just says, yeah, you're not going to have a one guy, like in disguise, you're not going to have Killia there to carry you. Everyone has to work. Everyone is the same. But what that does allow is, like what that commander lady said, where new recruits are at the same level as the people you already have. So switching people out is not punished. It's not unrewarded. So, like, taking people with bad things, like bad potentials, and instead swapping them with people with good ones is just better. So R&D is probably where you buy new weapons.
Welcome to R&D, man. What can I do you for? Wait, I know that insignia. You're Lieutenant Gunther, aren't you? I knew it! Man, I've heard about you! That evacuation at Brühl was just... wow! Protecting a tiny life in the middle of all that slaughter? Man! Oh, Lieutenant, you're good people! You get all my respect and then some, bro!
What's going on, Leon? I could hear you from clear across the hangar.
Oh, Casey, check it out! It's Lieutenant Gunther! He's the man!
Sorry about him, Lieutenant. He's like this all the time, I'm afraid. But where are my manners? I'm Kreese Cherney. I'm training here as a mechanic.
Oh, and I'm Leon Schmidt. But just call me Leon, bro. I'm your boy.
So, Lieutenant Gunther, what brings you down to R&D today? We do work here on weapons development, making upgraded weapons and equipment.
And that includes rifles and machine guns. We can even soup up your tank. Of course, research expenses aren't cheap.
With rifles and other firearms, we'll mass produce new models as they're developed. You won't have to worry about making enough for your squad. We'll outfit them.
For tanks, you can upgrade the baseline performance of the body itself, or develop optional parts that you can add on to tweak out its specs.
Right. You can choose which optional parts you want in the tank equipment section. Come in anytime and make adjustments based on the needs of the operation at hand.
About outfitting tanks. Development work on tank happened in the form of body enhancements, tread and weak point improvements, and attack support. Body enhancement mostly reinforce the gun barrel and body armor to improve its base stats. Tanks will automatically be given the best body type you have developed. Okay, that's nice. You decide whether to favor attack or defense, and altering body types gives your tank a different outward appearance. Improvements to support the treads and weak point and tech support take the form of parts that can be added to tanks to enhance their abilities. Each part has a set size in blocks. You decide how to fill the 4x3 block storage capacity in the Edelweiss. Pick the optional parts that best fit your own personal combat style.
Okay.
So, from what I understand, you use the money or whatnot, development thing to purchase like the upgrade. Uniform upgrade robot, and just gives you, that's not bad. Okay, blast suits, Edelweiss rifles. I guess that's not bad.
bro. It's done.
Okay. And I can't upgrade it again.
Sorry.
Okay. Machine guns. Well, yeah, I guess I can just do that. Okay. Okay. It's a decent up. And this is my sniper. And I do want this to do more damage. Just because sniping, probably one of the best things ever. And I can't improve that yet. And might as well just give everyone a base defense boost. And I guess I'll give them this as well. Okay. So let's outfit tanks. Okay, any more parts? Develop weapons for the Edo Weiss. Our body enhancements. I can reinforce the barrel, which gives me more range, or reinforce the armor, which gives me more body, which aren't bad. Treads and other. Spare treads radiator. So critical defense is that. Spare belt is tread HP plus. Attack support. Sight upgrade. Bulletproof visor. Accuracy plus 5. I'm gonna get this, because accuracy is very important. Yeah, you should equip that. Okay. I'm just gonna do body enhancements. Give me more range.
All set.
Okay, and now it tells me I don't have enough. Which is nice. It's nice when things tell you. Exactly. It's like, yeah, you can't afford this, you're poor. Okay.
Well, sir, was that helpful?
Indeed, it was.
We're working here around the clock to make possible tomorrow what's out of reach today. Come again a little later. We'll do our best to have something useful for you by then.
So I'm guessing it's like every chapter.
Yeah, you better come back soon, bro. I am all fired up to work on stuff for you.
And I'm guessing I'll get more facilities after, because that you don't want to just have 3 random blocks. So back to book mode. Yes. So I can advance the story. What? No. No. No, I haven't saved in so long. Fuck. 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 Damn it. How long has it been since I saved? Please tell me I don't have to redo. Load game. Where is it? Oh, please tell me. Oh my god, thank you. Okay. Well, this sucks. Okay.
Chapter 3. Vassal Urban Warfare.
To make sure I can still see that we're recording. Okay. Now back in. Get out of there. Okay. I'll see you guys in a little bit because... Fuck me. Okay, so back, got almost everything the same, I believe. So let's try book mode again, and let's hope it doesn't crash again. I'm just gonna do some different stuff. Okay. Okay, headquarters tab is now available. Battle headquarters on the Galleon Militia base. You can use the experience points of funds you acquire in battle, train troops to high level. Okay, stop and buy before combat or after NOP. Once you've acquired more resources, good idea. Open the menu with Y, pick headquarters from tab select, visit the base. Progress to the game, new destination around your base will become available to you as well. Y, save. Okay. Just making sure. Okay, good. Now I'm wondering, can I go back and, like, can I just do a battle again? I think that would be pretty fun. Although, that'll be in my spare time. I'll figure that out.
Welks. There you are. I've been looking for you.
Hey, Ys. How'd your enlistment go? No problems?
I registered as a tank pilot and mechanic. Maintaining and operating the Edelweiss will be my responsibility from now on. I think it's nice that we'll all be on the same squad together. I think so too.
So what are you up to now?
The tank's hangar space is just through here. I was just carrying some Ragnite fuel back. It's used to power the tank, and also for the turret-mounted cannon rounds.
I guess I'm just more used to seeing it in street lamps and medical compounds.
Seems like everything is Ragnite powered these days. That stuff is everywhere. Not enough of it for some people, though. It's the source of a lot of conflict.
They say the Empire's invading only to get at all the Ragnite in Galleon soil.
Oh, that's right. I had something to give you, Welt.
What's this?
Father's flare gun. It was in the barn, but I thought you might have some use for it.
Another hand-me-down.
I gave it a once-over. It might be old, but it's still serviceable.
I didn't mean... I just can't believe I'm a tank operator now. Thank you for this, Ys.
I'll do a spot check on the Edelweiss now, to make sure it's ready to go at any time. All right, we'll get going for now then. See you later.
Episode, first up.
I'll cut to the chase. Here's your mission. The Great Vassal Bridge was just taken by the Empire. It's a key strategic position.
The Great Vassal Bridge?
It's a major drawbridge crossing the canal in Vassal, just outside the capital.
That bridge is a part of the central transit artery, leading into Randgreaves. Our mission is to take it back. The Empire has been running a blitz, with their shock troops outrunning their defense. Our 3rd Regiment will retake the bridge before defensive reinforcements can arrive.
How quaint. The militia holding a little strategy meeting of its own. How long were you planning on hiding out in here, Verrat?
My apologies, sir. We'll depart soon.
Whatever. They're just country mice. It's not like they'll be much help.
Fuck you, man.
More help, perhaps, than your army unit that couldn't hold the bridge in the first place.
Hey!
Regardless, Vassal remains a critical position. We'll reclaim it immediately.
Well, good. See that you do.
Who was that?
General Damon, commander of the Central Forces.
Central Forces? That's the army branch the militia was folded into, right?
That's right. They say the general's an aristocrat. He looks down on the common militia.
That doesn't make any sense.
Right. Now that the war's begun, we all need to band together and fight to keep Gallia safe. Who cares at this point whether you're in the army or the militia? It's ridiculous.
Gentlemen, let's return to the mission. We'll begin by taking back the western bank to gain a foothold for reclaiming the bridge. Lieutenant Gunther, I'm assigning Squad 7 to this mission. It's your first maneuver, so be smart.
Yes, Captain.
The other squads are on patrol. Stay sharp and be ready to help take back the bridge. I'm counting on all of you out there. Now move out.
Skirmishes tab. Now skirmishes. Like those in the main storyline, players found under the skirmishes tab can be played any number of times. Okay. So that means I can't go back and do a battle. Prepare for amassing experience and research fees. Try them if you're feeling underpowered. Press Y to open the menu, and then choose skirmishes from the tab select menu and pick the battle you wish to fight. New skirmishes are added as you progress through the main plot, and the difficulty of each skirmish can be set freely. Just be careful. Though not a plot battle, soldiers lost during skirmishes can still die. Oh, what? Okay. So, there's sort of like a Fire Emblem-y thing going on here. Where if a character dies, you don't get him back, but you just recruit another for free. So let's tap select. What's going on with skirmishes? Outskirts of rule. Oh, okay. I get it. So basically what it does is it just changes the story battle into a skirmish, it seems like. So that's going to be some me time right there. So let's save before heading out. And let's go kick some tail.
Here are details on the current operation.
The Imperial force deployed in defensive formation around a camp within the urban center. You will assign your squad positions split between a city team and a riverside team. Okay. City team will protect the base camp while the riverside team strikes the enemy. Your objective is to occupy the enemy's camp. Defeat the enemy units defending the camp. Get to the flag hung above their camp to occupy it. Beginning with this operation, you will be responsible for assigning your soldiers to their combat positions. Before commencing the operation, choose the position units command. Choose the position units command to view a list of deployable units. Then, once you select a unit you'd like to deploy, choose the position you wish them to take. The Talos report says they have tanks stationed in the city area. Behoove you to include an anti-tank unit on the city team to facilitate its neutralization. I'd also recommend you add units with high AP, such as scouts and engineers, to your riverside strike force. Okay. Once you've got your team in place, select deploy command to begin the operation. Now, time to get the soldiers of yours into position. Enemy base camp is captured. Enemy occupies Gallia's base camp. All ally soldiers and reserves are killed. Welkin dies. 20 turns pass. Okay. So, 3 members, limit 4. So, okay. So here I want to, right now, who's in there? How do I tell? I'm guessing the O1s are the ones that are already deployed. Yeah, I can't. So, he likes Largo Montley and Walter. So that's good. Thanks, Kevin and Newt. Okay, so I need a tank guy here. So let's put you there. And God fucking damn it! Sorry, that was unneeded anger. Fuck you! 800 service people. Hate them. Okay, so I'm gonna put a shock trooper here. And I feel like a sniper wouldn't be too bad. Sniper wouldn't be too bad on this team. Okay, so the people in it right now. Okay, so we got a tank guy. Let's put a mechanic out here. Okay, so the annoying thing is it says likes, but some of the people aren't on my team. Like, there are people that aren't there. So I'm gonna put them there. Okay, and I can get one more. So we have sniper, shock trooper, we have lancer, and we already have sandbags there, so I'm actually going to put another shock trooper, should I? Or actually, I have a lot of scouts. But these guys are defending camp. So I'm gonna want... I'm actually gonna take you. It's hard because... You know what? Fuck it. I'm gonna take you, put you there. Just keep everything good. Let's deploy.
We're prepared to commence the operation. I look forward to good news from you.
Ah, well.
Split into two teams, offensive and defensive. Squad 7, move out!
Okay.
All right, it's our first mission. Let's split into two teams, City and Riverside.
I already did.
I'll lead the Riverside team towards the enemy encampment with the Edelweiss.
Shock Trooper here. Leave the offense to me.
City team, your job is to guard the base. Be ready for anything, including tanks.
How long you think I've been an anti-tank man? A couple of tanks ain't no sweat.
That's a spirit, Largo. Now, let's move out!
Listen closely. This information could save your life.
They're occupying camps. Camps found across the battlefield can enforce a number of advantages. Units stationed near camps get a boost to their D and to the amount of HP recovered at the start of each turn. Even tanks, which usually get no HP bonus, will regain some HP at each turn start. Weapons with limited ammo like grenades, mortars, and lances are also replenished. If there are enemies around a camp, however, you cannot occupy it until they have been defeated. Effectively defending your camps while taking down enemies will pave your way to victory. Okay, so camps are good. Okay, so got a couple scouts. So let's...
Ain't no stopping me.
Strong willed. Okay, I hit crouch. Let's move my tank.
Do all you can to minimize casualties.
do is this. Cool.
Good work. Keep it up.
Now I'm gonna end that. And I don't really want to move anyone here, because I can just wait for them. So
my turn, okay?
Oh wow, they have all these guys have a lot of move. About terrain actions. Some locations on the battlefield, A will do something. Crawl. Hide within and out of view. Okay, so they can't see. Also, climbing ladder can allow unit roof access. Keep an eye out for other useful actions. Okay.
Look out for attackers from the alleys.
Enemy unit spotted. Enemy unit spotted. Enemy unit spotted.
Three. Good. Not an attacker. Just took out a shock trooper. But leader units, a CP symbol is displayed above, is displayed beside the names of some units on their profile. These units are known as leaders as they exist among both allied and enemy forces. In Squad 7, Alicia is one such leader. By including them on the field, they'll each add one CP to your total. That's amazing, allowing you to control more units per turn. If a leader is defeated, however, that CP is subtracted from the pool. Keeping your leader units protected while actively seeking out and destroying enemy leaders to reduce their CP pool. Okay. That's good. I had no idea that that's what it actually was. When I really thought I'd be able to take cover behind those benches. Okay, so I have 5 left. I should move Carl up. I want to move him up because next time the tank moves or if it needs to get healed. And that's an alleyway. With a ladder, so I can put someone up there. Let's see if there's... Okay. Her stay there. They'll be okay. And current action. Okay. So got a light tank. Tanks are probably gonna come down this way. Do here is I'm going to.
You still have sufficient ammo.
I'm going to park you right here. That way, when he comes through, just be able to destroy that guy. Damage. And I'm gonna end here. That way I can preserve a CP. Ooh, I didn't even see that shock trooper up in the top right. In the grass. Aw, damn it. The guy's at okay, cool. I was wondering, like, couldn't tell who he was attacking. Okay. So that's a scout. He was crawling. And that's just a shock trooper. Ty the Immortal. Oh my god. Okay. Did not realize that. About orders. S7K issues special commands. Orders cost CP, but some yield squad-wide effects that can be invaluable. Issue an order. Y. Choose a specific order you'd like to issue. Some orders will affect audience, other cards will affect the target. New orders can be learned by leveling up. Yep. Okay, so Y orders. Evade boost. Raise one ally's evasion. So that's one ally. Okay, so I want to move her.
My turn, okay.
Because right now she's out in the open.
Enemy sighted. Enemy sighted.
Take them out, one at a time.
Enemy unit spotted. Enemy sighted. Now.
Okay, just take that guy out.
Just keep up this pace.
And move her back.
What is that tank?
To keep a view on everybody. Okay, so that was good decision on my part, I think. I'm going to
go down.
Shit. Sweet. So for right now, I'm going to move him up. I believe that there is friendly fire, possibly. Yeah, that hit a fucking tree. Her.
Yeah.
Just get rid of them.
Who are these guys?
Just gonna end it here. Some damage. Not worried about that person being out in the open, because I don't think a shock trooper can move far enough. Anything. So now, right now, I'm going to get ready to tie the Immortal.
Here I come. Ain't no stopping me.
Use her again to kill him.
Here I come.
Shit. God damn it. Okay, so I guess I have to wait. Okay, so that was a good learning experience. What I have to do is I have to use it Then I have to wait for him to stand up. Come on, stand up, you fuck.
Go down.
Okay, never mind. Killed him. I'm just gonna get him. As of right now, I don't particularly. Okay, so that's a light tank and it's moving in this direction. So I think it's probably gonna try and come this way. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to. I'm guessing it's somehow gonna go through this building. Because the only space is right in that little spot. I don't think a tank could fit through the alleyway. Hey, doing some damage. Good job.
Minor damage sustained.
Yeah, that's fine. I like how I can't say I'm a fan of how okay, so went through the wall just like I predicted.
Gah, damn tanks busted right through the stinking wall. Well, it's my turn now. Stick this in your pipe and smoke it.
Stay sharp. Tanks can break through crumbling walls and trample down sandbags and trees.
As I predicted. Oh god. That did a lot of damage to Dallas. Enemy moving. Oh, don't shoot Dallas. Please don't. Okay. Good. Okay. So, first things first. About ammunition. Each weapon holds a set quantity of ammo that equates to the number of times that weapon can be fired in battle. For example, if the ammo reads 3, that weapon can be fired 3 times before it is out of ammo, therefore unusable. Weapons with limited ammo include anti-tank lances, snipers, grenades, mortars, other explosives, so on. There are 3 ways to regain spent ammo. One is to wait a turn. Okay, one use is automatic. Second is recovery by approximating to an allied camp. Units staying within camps are restocked to full capacity each turn. Third is restocking via engineer unit. Okay. Okay. So what I need to do is take out this tank. Try and get rid of this mechanic. Or engineer. Oh god. Okay. Didn't realize that.
Report. What is the enemy up to there?
Okay. I'm trying to end turn as much as soon as possible because I don't want more, like, just stray bullets coming in. Oh, god damn it. Okay. One shot, one kill. Good. And less CP, which is nice.
I'm not done yet.
Kinda wish I had done that prior to having the shock trooper move up. But oh well. Okay. And I need to take care of the enemy tank. Okay. So I'm gonna enter target mode. She's just essentially out of the battle now. I don't care. Because she also gives me another move. So it's very useful. Like Largo, he gives me another move. So that's really nice. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move again.
Entering combat.
Get a second hit in. Move up a little bit. Just to make sure nothing can do anything. Now I could do that. I could just kill that guy, but I'm not worried about it. So what I am going to do is this. The reason why I'm doing that is because I want him to move up. Heal it. Didn't mean to do that. Okay. I can't do anything else, but he has grenades, which would be useful.
Watch out for hidden enemies.
So that I'm going to pull back to here in current action. And end phase. Wendy is just a pro. And now they can't move anymore. Because this.
So
what I'm going to do is I am going to move through here. Take that guy out like that. Aiming mode.
Now.
Kill the tank. Because they don't have lancers. Yeah, I'm going to end that action. Okay, so I have a bit of time. I'm gonna move up with the sniper. See if I can get anyone. Shock trooper. Just take him out. Yep, let's move.
I'm not done yet.
Okay. Move her with her again. Okay. Okay. Aim. Take him out.
I'm not done yet.
You're doing well. Just keep it up.
End of there. And
I'm on
with
it.
Her. Him out. Okay.
Moving out.
Looks like there's something in that.
Please help.
Glad I remembered about grenades. Okay. End that action. And now all the enemies are dead.
I'm on it.
I have a feeling Ty the Immortal was meant to be like a, occupy the camp. Yeah, that one was... Oh man, that was fun. And no one died.
Operation complete. We took their base.
Oh, yeah, that feels good. Like, look at all that stuff. Ooh, I seized an enemy weapon. Which is nice. I wonder if that's better than a weapon I have. New episode has been added. So why? Gonna save. Ugh, right there. Okay, so... not sure how long we've been going through it, so we can at least talk, like, do a couple of the cutscenes, and then I'll go to the town and upgrade some stuff.
Hey there! You guys aren't with Squad 7 by any chance, are ya?
Yes, that's us.
Bingo! I've been looking for you. Meaning you, Hot Stuff, on the tank.
Me?
Mm-hmm. Excuse me, I...
That must make you Lieutenant Gunther, am I right?
Yeah. Yes, that's me.
Oopsie-daisy!
What? Hey, you can't...
Ah, nice to meet you, too. Now, let's get right to the questions. So, you're the son of the great General Gunther, huh? You look awfully young. How old are you, anyway? Must be your first war, huh? What's been the hardest experience so far? Happiest. Funniest. I'd also like to know hobbies, favorite foods, what you do on your days off.
Hey, lady! This is a combat zone. Excuse me, but what are you doing here anyway?
Hey, give me a break, will ya? Scoops are near danger, and I'm near Scoops. That's right. The name's Ellet. I'm GBS Radio's top woman reporter. I smell a story. A good story. And you guys are in.
So, you're a reporter?
Very good, I'm a reporter, yes. I've been assigned to Squad 7 to conduct a series of interviews, thank you. Now, let's get back to those questions, shall we?
Pushy reporter character, of course. Ooh, distrust. Ooh, do you not trust me? I just led you guys into battle and defeated enemies. And was very good.
Now he's giving interviews? Who does he think he is?
Well, I think I am Mr. Gunther.
Ooh, look at him. Son of some big hero. Please, he's still a schoolboy.
Hey, fuck you, I just led you to victory.
No kidding.
Oh, fuck you, Largo.
One little win and he's the new Grand Duke.
I didn't even want the interview.
Whatever. He'll learn soon enough. Only one thing matters out there in the field, and that's experience.
So let's go grind. So that was a completely rather pointless thing.
Chapter 4, Operation Cloudburst.
Okay, that's a pretty cool name. That's pretty cool. That's a pretty cool name. I'll be completely honest. Personnel tab is now available. Weaponry tab is now available. Glossary tab is now available. About personnel, weaponry, and glossary. Do tabs offer information on the game's cast, the arms they wield, and the things and places that form their world? Okay. Contents are automatically updated. Okay, so that Castle Front Street is now available. War Cemetery is now available. Personnel tab has been updated. Updated. Okay, so that just gives you the flavor text. And tab select, scrimmages, personnel. Oh wow. Fuck. That's a lot. What's going on, Thamer? Sarah's biological father and gifted Darkson inventor who contributed much to the Galleon technology, but the Edelweiss for his friend after European War One. What's up, Nils? Hey, Nils Dearden. Squad 7 Lancer, H29, dozen of Capitalist City's seedy underbelly. His was a solitary life. He remained undefeated through countless turf wars. Oh, we got a gangster up in this bitch. Okay. I don't mind that. Okay. So, with that, I am going to end this episode. So, I hope to see you all, or hope to commentate a game to you, everybody, in the next episode. So, I hope you all have a very nice day.